What's up, people? It's about to go down. Today, what we're going to do is give you a little insight to the fights over the weekend. One that we had a very in-depth interest in, which is Tony Ferguson versus one of the premier Gaethje. I just can't say enough about his performance, but what we're going to do is give you a little demonstration. And for those who don't know me, my name is Coach Eric A. Bradley, and this is Stacy.
Hey, everybody. Glad to have you with us
today. Team Master Boxing. And what we're going to do is give you a demonstration. Now, we had a vested interest in this fight over the weekend. One of my former fighters and a guy I was an advisor for, Rashad Holloway, is the head coach of Tony Ferguson. So we had a very in-depth interest into this fight. But what came out of this is one of the things that I didn't expect to see, that I did see, is not any adjustments being made. Now, I will speak to the science of Rashad Holloway, who was a pugilist, amateur and professional fighter. Only injuries took him out of the sport. And one of the things we always spoke to is prevention. But when I saw what happened on Saturday night, it was obvious that when I get on the horn with him, I want to find out specifically, was Tony Ferguson not listening? Why are you asking me that? Because he was getting hit with right hands all night. And why do I ask that? It's because Rashad Holloway was one of the best defenders of the straight right hand in boxing. And he could take it away. And I just couldn't figure out why Tony was allowing that hand to land all night long.
So let's speak exactly to that. What could have been done to take that right hand away? What would that have looked like? What should have been done?
The first thing that you're taught in a camp of this, at this height, where we had all world champions in our camp, everybody was a champion at least. And the key was, how did this not be translated in the corner, and how did it get away from camp? One, two training camps back to back, two dryouts in a matter of months could do that to you, for one, mental sharpness. But the first thing that he could do was whenever, and this is the stance that I'm standing in right now could be named the Rashad Holloway, because this is where he stayed, and he fought in the pocket. And I want you guys to take the time to really take note to this, because this is serious stuff right here. So you MMA fighters, you got to get on this game, because if not, that same thing can happen to you. But the first thing that he could have done to take away the right hand is first circle away from it. Now, I'm in reverse right now, so if I'm like this, I look conventional. But one of the things that you got to do is take the right hand away with a twist of the hip and that front leg, and roll that shoulder. Make sure the chin is tucked behind it. You're right here as well. And this elbow is there. So when the shot either lands there, but that right hand was coming straight down the pipe. And this is how you roll the shoulder. Pop. And there's a slight tilt. So, but as you can see, that back leg has the weight on it. So you can pivot around after the shot lands. But what we did not see is him rolling. He was constantly playing hands low, kick getting caught straight. And all you have to do to hit someone with that lead, pop, pop, is follow it with a hook. And that's what was happening. He was catching bam, bam, with a hook, following the right hand all night. Then.
Yeah. So then Gaethje had a mean jab too. Same thing. What could he have done? What would have the adjustment in the moment? What should that have been?
This is the first thing. In boxing, catching is a serious thing. But in the Philly shell posture, which is what I just showed you, rolling the shoulder, and when you see that jab coming, Gaethje got very comfortable throwing the jab because he kept landing it. So, I mean, throwing the right hand. So he started calming down, as his coach said, which is why I just cannot figure out why that adjustment wasn't made by Tony. He just wasn't making an adjustment. But once he got in the pocket, what he should have done is prevent the jab from coming. Gaethje was throwing a jab. He was stepping on it. It was very solid, stiff. It meant to do damage. But all Ferguson would have needed to do, instead of trying to outshift all of the punches, which you cannot do over a period of time, it'll catch up to you, was in the box in the Philly shell posture. You pop, 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 and pop. You catch the jab. That's the first thing you do. There's 7 points in the Philly shell defense, and it covers 7 points of the body, preventing anything from landing when it comes down to fist strikes. And that's what he should have been able to do, because that's one of his coach. That's just like Mike Tyson not throwing a hook and his fighter. That's like one of Mike Tyson's fighters not throwing a hook. It makes no sense, because Holloway is an avid defensive fighter and a just meticulous defensive prowess, and never allow more than 2 punches to land at the same time. You might catch him with one shot, but you're not going to catch him with the second, because you train by Olympic coaches, work with elite amateurs, the top fighters in the game, work with the tight fighters in the sport. So that should have never happened, especially after the second round. By the second round, the adjustment, the data should have been collected. And when it's all said and done, Tony Ferguson was making the most mistakes when it comes down to his offense, because he was throwing punches, leaning over his front foot, and subjecting him to get hit with those punches. And I tell you, fighters, you gotta learn one thing. It's education when it comes down to striking, that your defensive prowess stay right there at the level that your offense is. He got ahead of himself, and I think it had a lot to do with the weight cuts. 2 consecutive times, one fight went through, and then, you know, it happened right at the beginning of the pandemic. But fighters, let me explain something. You cannot avoid learning and continuously learning these tactics that offer in Muay Thai and in boxing, because when it's all said and done, all of the guys who come into that forum learn so many things that they never knew existed for them to use in the sport of mixed martial arts.
Absolutely imperative.
It's imperative.
If not, you see what happens.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
And so, like I said, we're doing damage control. We got to connect with our people and make sure everything's good. It looks like Tony Ferguson was in the hospital having fun, you know, with his up to his old shenanigans, dancing with the pole. So, you know, shouts out and blessings to him. Send the prayers out to him and his family, and even Justin Gaethje, who's going forward and moving on to bigger and better things right now against Khabib Nurmagomedov. So it's going down, man. So I hope you guys enjoyed the post. If you know someone that's in the game right now, mixed martial arts, make sure you tag them if they watch UFC. And until next time, Coach Bradley signing out
with Stacy here
in the building. This is Master Boxing.
See you next time.
You get
time.
Your master's in boxing. Bam, bam. Billy Shell.